Hi, my name is Gertse and I'm going to show you how to model this cup, how to add the texture, and let's go to Blender, delete the default cube, add a cylinder. I'm going to delete the middle vertex, I'm going to press Alt, and I'm going to select any of these vertexes around the edge of this cylinder. Press E for extrude. S to scale. I'm going to scale it in just a little bit. I'm going to press 3, 1, 5 to go into the front orthographic view. I'm going to press Z to go into wireframe mode, E to extrude, Z for the Z axis. And I'm going to pull this down. Go back into solid mode. It's more like it. Let's go to the front orthographic view again. Going to add a loop cut there. In case you don't know how I did that, you can select it from this panel as well. Loop cut. You can place it anywhere on the cup. This is just for the handle of the cup. Anywhere on the cup, let me put it there and press Alt and this button and just bring it up again just a little bit more so it won't be near the edge of the cup. I'm going to add another loop in there. Now I'm going to select the 6 vertexes. I'm going to press 3. And I'm going to press spin. Now what this does, it actually spins this thing to the wrong side. I want it to spin right around the side. Let me just press minus 90. That's more like it. But it still doesn't look the way I want it to be. So just undelete that. And the reason why, because this cursor is in the middle of this Y and this X axis. If you go to the top view, you will see the cursor there in the middle. And I want the cursor to be in the middle of this line only. Now, in order to do that, you come to select this vertex, press Shift and this vertex. Then I'm going to press Shift S and cursor to select it. And what that does, you go to place a cursor in the middle of that line instead of here. In the middle of this center. Now I'm going to select that 6 vertexes again. Press 3 again. Okay, now if I press spin, it's still spun the wrong way. So I'm just going to add minus 90. Now it's spinning the right way. And spin just halfway. I want it to spin all the way to touch the side of the cup. So I'm going to add another 90 minus 180 degrees. And that's more like it. I press 3. You can see it's not touching this cup completely. And in order to do that, I'm going to wireframe mode. Select this side, and then that side. I'm going to press W, merge, and last. The same with this. Merge last. Okay, I'm going to do it for all 6 sides. I'm going to select this first one, and then the last one, and I'm going to W, merge, last. The first, the last, W, merge, last. Okay, I'm going to do the same here, this middle one. To press. This is the bottom part of the handle. Okay. W, merge, last. Now I can see all the 6 Vertex is connected. And now I'm going to press A to select the whole cup. I'm going to press, I'd rather leave the shortcut. Let's go to this spinner and just add subserve modifier. Going to add, give it two subdivisions. I'm going to press tab. Now I can see it's like that awful looking, I don't know what you call it, around the cup. But in order to fix that, press tab again and then you press loop cut and slide and place a loop cut and slide there. Loop cut and slide. As you can see, it's not going right around that corners. In order to fix that, look at the slide, it's not going to work there. In order to fix that, I'm going to press Z. With all this, faint lines, it's a bit confusing. In order to minimize a few of that lines, you press optimal display. Now I'm just going to select that six vertexes. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now I'm going to press Z. I just want you to see what's happening when I'm going to increase the mean crease. Just going to turn this up all the way to 1. Press N to hide that. Tab to go out, and now I'm going to smooth this out. And smooth. As you can see here, the bottom of this, the handle of this cup, it looks, there's an awful looking bump or dent. It looks more like a bump. In order to remove that, you go into the add modifier and you're going to add the add split. That will get rid of that awful looking bump there. Now please first apply. I should have applied the subdivision or modifier first. To undelete, I press Ctrl Z and I'm going to apply that one first, and then I'm going to apply that one. Now you can see I've got a nice looking cup. But the edges of the cup, it looks a bit sharp. In order to fix that, going to tab. Okay, now I've already going to tab. Let's just undo this. Control Z. Add. Just tab to this here. Add the subserve modifier. Turn it up to 2. Smooth it out. Add split. Tab. Loop cut and slide. Yeah, in the middle. Select there. Okay. Loop cut and slide again. End of the cup. And now you say you can apply it. First you need to tap to go into object mode. Apply that and apply that. Now I've got a nice looking cup. Let's just add the plane. Press Shift S, cursor to center, Shift A, add the plane, press S to scale it up. Press 3 and bring that plane down to the bottom of this cup. And now if I render this, I press F12 to render. It looks like the cup is a bit in the air. Just press F12 again. 3 and just move that a tiny little bit up. F12 again. F12, going to press 7, move that side, I'm going to press right mouse button, split area, and I'm going to open UV image editor on this side. And on this side, I'm going to press tab to go into the edit mode. I'm going to press U, and I'm going to press project from view, and then I'm going to select the image that I'm going to use as the base or the material for that plane. Let's click wood plane. You can use any image. You can even take a photo with your cell phone or digital camera of any surface, and then you can load it into your computer, whatever. If I press here, texture, you can see it apply the texture. But if I press F12, it didn't apply the texture to this plane. And in order to do that, I'm going to this button here, to this material. I'm going to add material, and then I'm going to this texture button. I'm going to add new. I'm going to add image or movie, and then I'm going to select that picture that I've selected on the side. I'm going to select here, and then I'm going to use UV. I'm going to press S, scale it up. If you look on the left side, you can see what's happening to that image. I'm just going to scale it up there. Press F12, S, scale it up more. F12, S, scale it up more. F12. Okay, that's more like it. I'm going to leave it like that. I'm going to add another texture. I'll click the second texture, add new. I'm going to select the same texture, and I'm just going to give it its own properties. Go to turn up the contrast. Turn down the brightness. Now I'm going to select the UV. And also, I'm going to click on the intensity. And if you render this F12, you can see it gives a nice glossy, finish to this wood. Now, in order for you to see this grain of this wood, to make it stand out, you click on there. Turn this down, press 0.2, enter, F12, and now you can see that bumps and that grooves, the tiny grooves in the wood. That looks too much. Let me just turn the bit down a bit more, 100, F12. Okay, that doesn't look so bad. Okay, that looks more nice. Now let's go into the compositor. But before we go to compositor, let's give this cup a color. Press F12, tab to go to object mode. Go to select the cup. 3 is more, bring the cup up again, a bit more up. Z, a little bit up, because I cannot see the bottom of this cup. Now that's more like it. I'm going to select that cup, give it the material, turn up the intensity. That is just to give that shiny finish on that cup. That's, you see that that shiny part on there. If I turn this down, that shiny part is gone. If I turn it up, shiny part is there. I'm just going to give that cup a nice color, make it like a green color, green, yeah, an incredible walk. I'm going to turn up the hardness, make it 100. If I render this, let's see. Okay, that's